సందీప్, అక్కడ కూడా అడ్మిషన్ వచ్చినా, సో లెట్స్ వెయిట్ ఫర్ అట్లీస్ 8-3
ఓకే
సో దట్ పీపుల్ గెట్ ఇన్.
ఓకే
संदीप
राइट. जय जगन्नाथ. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ उड़िया समाज दिल्ली, आई वेलकम यू ऑल. आई थैंक यू ऑल फॉर हैविंग टेकन आउट टाइम, इवन दो इट इज 8 o'clock इन द इवनिंग नाउ, बट इट इज हार्टनिंग टू सी दैट मोर देन 80 पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव जॉइंड अस टुडे. जस्ट टू गिव अ ब्रीफ बैकग्राउंड फॉर ऑल दोज हु हैव जॉइंड टुडे, वी आर विटनेसिंग एन अनप्रेसिडेंटेड सर्ज in COVID related infection and the complications that are happening all over the country. Yesterday the count went up to around 3.30 lakhs and it is expected that in the next 15-20 days the surge is going to pick up. That's what people are saying, the experts are saying. Due to this surge, there are scarcity in all respect, be it medical facilities, be it hospital admission and so on and so forth. And the primary scarcity that is being felt by many patients who are suffering from COVID is lack of consultations from doctor who are trained to provide medications. And for that, Odia Samaj has joined hands with VVO Health to provide telemedicine platform, which will be started soon in the next few days. But apart from that, we have also seen that due to COVID related ailments, those who are suffering from COVID, along with their families, they are going through a great deal of stress. And therefore, we also decided to start a program which will talk about our well-being, which will talk about our wellness. And to that end, today we are going to start the first chapter of our wellness program. Odia Samaj has joined hands, as I said, with yoga exponents, with other motivational speakers who have gone through lots in life, who have made a name for themselves as a motivator, as a yoga instructor, and they have seen things from the close quarters. And it has been established, it has been proved that yoga does play a role, and therefore the first episode, so to say, or the first chapter of our wellness program would start with yoga program also. Apart from that, we have seen that COVID-related elements also affect our entire well-being, and heart, our body, our heart also gets affected. And therefore, we requested Dr. Raut Rai, who is the chief of SCB Medical Cardiology Department. He is with us today. I welcome you, sir. He'll be talking about how to take care of our well-being and the well-being of our heart, which is the most vital part of our body. We also have two yoga exponents from the Sri Sri University who will be conducting yoga session, Dr. Dinesh Prasad Swai and Dr. Pratibha Sri. I wholeheartedly welcome both of you, sir and madam, for being here. And it will be a great opportunity for us to learn yoga and to learn the nuances of yoga and how yoga is going to help us in these trying times. We'll start the program. I would request our president, Siddharth Pradhan, sir. He's the president of Odia Samaj. He has been a distinguished bureaucrat who made a name in whatever assignment he was given by the government of India. And post-retirement, he has been involved with many socio-cultural activities, centering Odisha primarily. And he has been our motivator, prime motivator, insofar as the Odia Samaj activities are concerned. And just to share an anecdote that all these programs, which we are talking about now, was chalked out and is being now implemented within the record span of 7 days' time. And all this happened thanks to Siddharth sir's persistence and guidance. I'll request Siddharth sir to give the inaugural speech for this webinar.
Thank you, Sandeep. Jai Jagannath. Namaskar to all my fellow Odias, fellow Indians, and Indians of diaspora in all parts of the world. We are passing through a very, very difficult time for the country. We are in dire strait. Hundreds of thousands of people are being infected every day. It is a world record that we have been infected with 3.3 lakh people in a single day. Never it has happened any place in the globe. At this rate, in next 3 days, we'll have 1 million infected patients in this country. Our health system is at breaking point. At times, we have no answer to the crisis at hand. Some of we thinking Odias, we decided that let's join hands and help the society at large, the Indians who are really suffering. How they should be treated, what type of treatment they should have, after treatment, how do they recover, what is a wellness program. These are all very well thought out by our Odia team, our doctors, our psychologists, and nutritionists also. In our series, every week we'll have two sessions helping out the people at large, the patient who will ask such a question to doctors every day. It is through telemedicine, the Vivio network, the Estonian company who have come forward to give us free service. We salute them at this time of crisis. We have banned up about 120 doctors who have already registered to give free services at least 1 hour per week for the roster duty so that they could render service to the infected patients and also give solace and peace to that suffering. In this long series, which you have started, we are today starting with Dr. Satyanarayan Raut Rai, Professor and Head of Department of Cardiology of SCB Medical College. Professor Rautre has a distinguished career. He is not only MD, but he is DM in cardiology. And he is member of many societies in India. He is a vice president of the Indian College of Cardiology, member of the editorial board of the Indian Heart Journal. He is a state PI for National Heart Failure Registry. He is life member of Cardiological Society of India. He is an affable person, always smiling. But the most important aspect which I have observed of Professor Rautre is that he's a very helpful and a very pious individual. Though he's an eminent doctor of the country, he has no heirs. He goes out of the way to give succor to the patients. And as always, as my father used to tell, that we don't treat the disease, we treat the patient at large. That motto is well endowed with Dr. Rautre, who not only treats the patient and the disease, more so looks after the patient's need, the patient's well-being, and how best the patient to recover from disease. In this time of COVID, Professor Rautre has given time to give his talk how to face the COVID menace, which is sweeping the country, sweeping the world at large. May I now request Professor Satyanand Rautre to please join and give his talk to us and enlighten us how best to face this misery which we are confronting right now. Over to Dr. Rautre. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for these kind words. Very good evening to all of you. In this COVID scenario, when, as we heard, the condition are deteriorating day by day, whole humanity is facing a challenge. So why this anxiety? Why this health anxiety? Because you see, within a short span of time, this first wave went out and second wave came. The whole world is affected, all six continents are affected, more than 250 countries are affected. And because of communication, because of modernization, it has spread very quickly. So the COVID-19 is a disease, is a new viral disease. We do not know clearly about the virus. When our scientists were finding path to find out the transmission, their pathogenesis, disease expression, presentation, all these things, this virus changed, it's mutated and changed the gene. Now it's coming in a different way. So all these things had put us into the anxiety. So this health anxiety that we are going to deal today, this is mainly with the uncertainty of the disease course, uncertainty in the management, uncertainty in the vaccine efficacy and safety, which has come up. So who are the patients under stress? If you see, the whole humanity is under stress because it's affected one and all in some way or the other. If somebody is affected or family member is affected, relatives are affected, somehow or other, everybody is affected. So if you see, the most targeted group is the patients, doctors, and their relatives. We should not think doctors are not under stress. They are more stressed because we expect more from them. We expect best from them, where we do not know what is the cause, what is the effect or the management, all these things. So we'll have to tackle this situation in a different way. We'll have to think how we can tackle this situation. If you see, what is the source of health anxiety? If you see, this is a dreaded disease, quite dreaded. This spread very quickly. This spread is very fast. And if you see, within a short span of time, as sir was telling, it has affected so many population, and in the next few days or weeks, we'll see the peak involvement in India. This brings a fear. This fear brings a anger, depression, and this occurs a cycle of anxiety. And this is, I think, what we can say. Mostly, if you see this media, I mean, electronic media, print media, sometimes they show this horrifying news, scary news, personal experiences. Some go in the WhatsApp media. One day I saw a WhatsApp media because after seeing the news for 1 hour, a patient is sitting on the sofa, fully covered with a polythene bag. So this is how it is so scary and people are afraid of this. And that is why, how to tackle this? First you see how to tackle the source. Source means why the people are afraid of this. Because you see, we should show the authentic news and authentic source. I mean to say, three portals give authentic news. One is WHO, World Health Organization. Second is CDC, or Center for Disease Control from America. For us, third is Government of India portals. We should see news here. If you go to the news channels, because of that TRP, they show news, breaking news, same things several times, and which are horrified. So such things are to be avoided. Because you see, we should avoid seeing this so that you can break the cycle. And here comes the most important part, counseling. Counseling is more important because you see, the patients, doctors, their relatives, all are to be counseled. So to say, the all population are to be counseled. One thing is good part of it, you see, if 100 people are affected, 85 to 90% have mild disease. The mild disease is more common in India. Here, the case fatality rate is less than 1%, less than in all over world, about 5% need ICU care. Here, 2 to 3% need ICU care. So this is, you see the scenario, most of the people are safe, but we should not afraid. That's it. But at the same time, we should not neglect. We should not neglect the disease. We should know the symptoms, symptom scenario. You see, all of us know the symptoms. Such things are to be known by everybody. The disease is changing. You see, fever, myalgia, body ache, and sometimes headache, so common, skin eruptions, loss of smell, loss of taste, loss of appetite, all these many, the sore throat, all these non-specific symptoms of any viral disease are there, but loss of taste, smell, and appetite, these are very specific to viral disease, particularly COVID-19. Here it comes, why? Not all people need oxygen, not people need hospitalization. The patients with mild disease, they can be managed at home. How to know which is a mild disease? Very simple. You need only one thing. You need a pulse oximeter. If you see, you can count the respiration rate. Three things. If the patient is having severe chest heaviness, breathing abnormality in the symptom, if the respiration rate is more than 30, if the oxygen saturation is less than 90, patient is severe. In such patients, if oxygen saturation less than 90, respiration rate more than 30, or patient is having breathing problem with chest heaviness, this is severe, they need oxygen support, they need hospitalization. Come to the mild and moderate. Both mild and moderate can be treated at home, though guideline says mild has to be managed at home and moderate need care of hospitalization, not to the ICU, but to the ward. See the situation now. Beds are not available. Oxygen is not available in the hospital. In this situation, how can we treat these patients at home? That is more important. Here you see, if the respiration rate is less than 24 per minute, if the oxygen saturation is 94 or more, if there is not much of symptom except some mild fever or myalgia, this is mild. They can easily be treated at home. But at the same time, one should not forget, today it is mild, tomorrow it may be moderate. So that's why we'll have to keep an eye. keep and we monitor the we should monitor ourselves we should monitor our relatives we should all these things we'll have to see. And in the moderate, we see the moderate means this respiration rate is 24 to 30, oxygen saturation between 90 to 93. They are moderate. You see, they may need oxygen, yet may not need oxygen. Such patients can be managed at home, but here we'll have to see the high risk subset. What are high risk subset? Patients with heart disease, patient with heart failure, patients with kidney failure, patient with cancer, patient with COPD or chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or asthma and related diseases, or patient with diabetes. There, they constitute a high risk subset. But now we see the second wave, the second virus which has come, it is affecting younger generation also. So that's why we'll have to monitor if there is deterioration of the symptoms, then we'll have to think the patient need hospital care. But if in moderate, you will have to give them certain drugs. I mean, immune boosting medications like vitamin C, vitamin D, zinc. And if they're found positive, they have to be given antiviral agent as quick as possible to help reducing the viral load. Because viral replication occurs in the first 5 days and maximum, then 5 to 10 days. And in the second week and third week, usually the host response become more, the immune, this because of increase in inflammatory markers. This is important. So you have to, this group of patients, they should be awake pruning. What we see, many media that are going on, this patient can sleep with belly, over the belly. I mean, face down or left lateral, right lateral, they change in 1 to 2 hours. By that, if you can maintain the oxygen between 92 to 96, then they can be managed at home. And one thing to be done, certain tests to be done, that everybody should know, we should know so that we can advise. So one is very common, complete blood count, C-reactive protein or CRP, hard D-dimer, and ferritin. Because in CRP is one of the important factor investigation to say, this patient is having going to develop some complications. Normally, in most of the laboratory, CRP level normal is below 6. Below 6 is normal. If 6 to 25, it is mild. If 25 to 100, this is moderate. More than 100, it is severe. Those patients having CRP high, they are likely to have cardiac and pulmonary complications. So such patients should be taken care of with hospital admission, or we should give them proper advice. So major chunk of people can be managed at home. So we should not be hopeless, because most of the people, most of the persons can be taken care of at home. At this point of time come our importance. What we have done, this telemedicine, for that I really appreciate this great idea by the Odia Samaj of New Delhi for this brilliant idea of creating a platform to give consultation to the people. Though many government hospitals have telemedicine facility, but we can add up to this, because everybody cannot approach to the government hospitals, to government hospital, because they're so busy in telemedicine. So telemedicine is become a platform where we can easily provide medical help to these persons. Here I will appeal my doctors, brothers and sisters, they should enroll in Odia Samaj telemedicine. This is being circulated, and we will also circulate further so that many people can volunteer to give the consultation and medical help in such a situation. And coming to the other aspect here, because all of us, the engineers are there, managers are there, bureaucrats are there, we all, not doctors, non-doctors and doctors, we all have to come forward, join hands for the greater cause of humanity, to save the humanity from this coming pandemic. Here I'll tell a few things before I hand over the mic. Here, you see, we need immune boosting and psychological boosting to break this fear, depression, anger cycle. What is the immune boosting medications? As I told,
they are very less important. Immune based boosting medications, but we'll have to wait. We'll have to rely on immune boosting foods. What are the immune boosting foods? Immune boosting foods are proteins, minerals, and vitamins. All these things have to be taken in a large amount. And super nutrients like almond, ginger, or adrak, garlic, turmeric, and green tea. These are definite importance to boost the immunity. If it boosts our immunity, it boosts our psychology also. And COVID patients are found to be deficient in vitamin C, vitamin D, and zinc. I'll say vitamin C is present in citrus foods. So lemon, half a lemon gives sufficient vitamin C for a day. So citrus foods like lemon, orange, and amla, all these things are citrus foods. And vitamin D has to be supplemented, otherwise we'll have to get it from the sunlight. And zinc is present in egg, and sufficient quantity in egg and milk. Sufficient egg and milk are to be taken. And second point comes exercise. Exercise means we doctors and bureaucrats, we sit most of the time on a chair. Sitting for more than half an hour in a chair is equal to smoking a cigarette. So we'll have to, every half an hour, we'll have to go from our seat, move around, walk 100 steps and come back. And all the time we should be active. If you get time, take some exercise, stretching exercise, walking. Breathing exercise is important in this situation because we'll have to take deep inhale and exhale. We'll take deep breath and take out. That breathing exercise is very important because in this situation, breathing exercise give immunity to our lungs. One of the important sleep that we mostly forget, we do mostly ignore. Because what happens, our body, when we sleep, our body go for a reparative mode. Whatever damage is done during the daytime in the different system, that get repaired during the sleep. So all of us need at least 7 hours, 6 to 8 hours of a sound sleep in a day. So this, our body has immense capacity to heal itself. And it is being supplemented by good sleep, exercise, and good diet. And coming to the other thing, the relaxation. You should relax. You should not get tense with this situation. To relax, you have to see movies, not on COVID. You can see, listen to the music, talk to your friends on good things, not on this all the things. Help others. This is very important. If you help others, going out of your field, a doctor seeing a patient is not helping. You have to go out of your field and help. You see that here the bureaucrats and others, they have come up for our cause. So you have to help others. If you help, that boost your immunity, boost your strength, boost your psychology, that you have helped someone today. And a positive attitude to life, this is very important. Positive attitude to life is always think, God has given me the best. Whatever I have got, always thank God. Because there are many people who have not achieved what we have achieved. So we should not look at others who are in higher. We should look at the lower so that we should help them. A society has contributed many things for us. Now it is time we should contribute to the society. That is very important. And this positive attitude, actually, this is the most important thing in this COVID scenario. Because you see, all diseases are psychosomatic. That means they have some disease, but mostly it is psychological part plays a major role. Here in COVID, the psychological part plays a major role. So you will have to take a positive attitude to life. Think whatever you have got, the best you have got. Think today is the happiest day of your life. Enjoy today, always like that. Accept the change. We'll have to accept the change. Have faith in God. This is very important. The positive attitude brings positive energy. The positive energy can help us in tide over the crisis. But at the same time, coming to the end of my talk, we cannot ignore three things. That is the basic things till now, using mask when going outside. When going outside, maintain physical distance of 6 feet. Do not go to a crowded place or enclosed place. Always wash your hands with soap and water or your alcohol-based sanitizer. And though the efficacy and safety are not 100% proof, take vaccine whenever your chance comes, unless it is contraindicated, like you have some allergy to certain things, or you have acute disease at that time, or during pregnancy. Otherwise, whenever a scope comes, take vaccine, get protection. Not only that, you protect yourself, you protect others also by that. So at the end, I pray the Almighty Lord Jagannath to bless all of us so that we can stay safe, we can stay healthy, we can stay happy. Thank you. Thank you all.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर आपण बहुत सुंदर भाव रे नॉट ओनली मेडिकल मेडिसिनल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू रु हमर जो वेलनेस जोटा में कहूँ मानसिक स्तर रे हम निज निज केमती सजग करके रखिबे ता ऊपर भी आपण आलोकपात कले ओडिया समाज तरफ रु आपको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आम इना जस्ट सर को भी कहते आजिकल कार समय व्हाट्सएप यूनिवर्सिटी मैंने किसी ना कि मात्र भरोसा करने को लगी दूर करने को आज आम जो सेसन करने को जाऊँ आम सांगे श्री श्री विश्वविद्यालय दीज रिसर्च स्कॉलर दीज प्रोफेसर इन योगा साइंसेस दिनेश स्वाई डॉक्टर दिनेश स्वाई और डॉक्टर प्रतिभा श्री आम सांगे अच्छा यो आम आसवा समय तीस मिनिट चालीस मिनिट तक मध्यम आम जानक योगा द्वारा केमती आम निज को निजे सतर्क करजर जो इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम अच्छी केमी स्ट्रेंथन मु रिक्वेस्ट करी श्री दिनेश स्वाई एंड डॉक्टर प्रतिभा श्री टू स्टार्ट
नमस्ते सर ऑडिबल सर
यस यस सर यू आर ऑडिबल मोस्ट वेलकम टू बोथ ऑफ यू सर यू वी मे स्टार्ट नाउ सर
थैंक यू लेट्स स्टार्ट द सेशन विद द टॉक संदीपा So, please sit comfortably, spine erect, hands on your knees, eyes gently closed. Have a smiling face. Widen your lips. Make sure that your spine neck and head in a straight line. Keeping your eyes closed, try to visualize your whole physical body from tip of the toes to top of the head. Keeping your eyes closed, try to visualize your whole physical body from tip of the toes to top of the head. Slowly, focus your awareness to match your breathing process. Without putting any effort, try to feel the length of your breath. Without putting your effort, just try to feel natural, spontaneous breath. Which starts from your body and continues up to this. Do not put any thought, just normal. Feel the length of your breath. Is it shorter or longer? Shallow or rhythmic? Once again, try to watch the length of your breath. Is it shorter or longer? Shallow or rhythmic? at the end of our session, again, we will watch the difference before practice and after practice. What is the difference in between? Now, slowly, shift your awareness towards your eyebrow center, in between your two and two. Where the Hindu lady puts her vermilion mark. They are visualized, a steady candle flame, which is golden and bright. In your eyebrow center, a steady candle flame. Feel the shape of the flame.
Louder.
Sir, Dinesh Babu, I'm sorry, Dinesh Babu. Take clear asni voice tap. I'm so sorry to be disturbing you.
Keeping your awareness there, we will chant Om three times. Keeping your awareness there, we will chant Om three times. So take a deep breath in. Om.
Feel the present state of mind. Now rub your palm and place in your closed eyes three times. Rub your palm and place in your closed eyes. Gently open your eyes. Have a smiling face. Yoga is a discipline to improve the quality of life. A philosophy to attain peace. If you want to experience health, if you want to experience peace and to evolve, make yoga a part of your lifestyle. Thank you, everyone. Now I am using the mic.
Namaste. Myself, Dr. Pratibha Shree. And first of all, I'll give thanks to the President Odia Samaj for such a beautiful thinking and during this pandemic, such a beautiful initiative for the entire globe, we can say. I'll give thanks to the speaker, Siddharth Sir. Was very nicely covering the things and giving the importance about the health while giving the importance to how to keep the build up the immune system. He was covering the exercise, he was telling about regular health checkup as well as the food habit and the entire lifestyle. Thank you, sir. And again, I'll give thanks to Ashok sir, Dr. Ashok sir, for giving this opportunity to share our little knowledge or experience in this field of yoga. Yes, yoga is the need of today, will be the culture of tomorrow. Because systematically it builds a discipline at the physio-psychological level and making us eligible to have the perfection to attain the goal of our life, that is the freedom. So there are, we can say, a number of techniques as given by our sages and saints as an invaluable gift to the human being in form of the different types of techniques. Like we will talk about the Hatha Yoga. They are beginning with the cleansing practices. As there is a saying that whenever there is the imbalance of the Kapha, Vata and Pitta, three humors, then there is some physio-psychological disorder. And so for that, we first of all, before going to the asanas, before going to the pranayam, or before going to the meditation, one should go for these cleansing practices. As in medical science, there is a saying that first of all, the doctors are prescribing the tablets. For quick recovery, there is the injection. Then for the instant recovery, there is the surgery. Similarly, in yoga also, the different techniques are there where asanas are playing just like the tablets, pranayams are playing just like the injections, and the cleansing practices, which are six in number, six cleansing processes, they are working just like the surgery, instant recovery from any problem will be there. So for that, I think many of the audience here present must have the idea about the neti, the nasal cavity cleansing practice, which is gel neti, means a pot of water needs to be taken with a, that is a lukewarm water with little salt. And a special pot is available for the neti practice, where the one of the, in one of the nostrils, the nozzles would be fixed properly under the guidance of the specialist in yoga. And then how the water will come out through the opposite one, similarly, it should be done with another nostril. So it is a cleansing practice, nasal cavity cleansing practice. Another technique is there, kunjal, for the stomach cleansing. And another technique is also there where the intestine will be cleansed, is known as the sankha prakshalan. And there are several other techniques are there, like Trataka is a technique which cleanses the mental impurities like Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Mascharya, and all these things. And Nauli is a practice to exercise or churn the abdominal muscles. So and Kapalbhati is another technique to cleanse the mental aspect of our being. So these are several cleansing practices, and we will start today with the asanas. To begin with the asanas, we will go for the such type of asanas during this COVID situation, how to have the immune power. That is, we'll begin with the chest expanding postures. Before going to the techniques, we'll start with Prajapati Asana. For this, we need to stretch out the legs in the front, and then bending at the knees, just bring the sole of the feet to the front of the body together, and bring the heels closer to the perineum, and interlocking the fingers needs to hold the feet. Back should remain straight, head should remain upright, eyes should remain closed, and then start shaking the knees up and down. Key point is to pull the heels closer to the perineum and put little effort so that knees will come down to the ground and up as much as possible. And while keeping the eyes closed, continue this practice and feel the sensation in the hips, stretching in the inner thighs. It's very good for the pelvic region, for the lower back. And now we can stop the practice and release the hands, stretch out the legs in the front. We'll go for the waistline, how to warm up the waist area or exercise the muscles here in the waistline. So for this Bhunamanasana, legs should remain straight in the front, and need to put the hands, both of the hands on the right side first. Can see the demonstrators, and put the head down in between the hands, then come off. Legs should remain together. Go to the opposite side and head down to the ground between the hands. Breathing in, come off. Back to the center. Breathing out. Twist the trunk to the right and head down, breathing out. Breathing in, come off. And breathing out. Go to the opposite side to complete this round. And while breathing in, come back to the center. And sit in a cross-legged posture. Breathing out, relax. Head upright, back straight. We'll go to the upper part of our body, that is to our shoulders, which are very important to exercise on the regular basis so that our chest cavity will be opened properly. And at the same time, there will be a good exercise of the upper back and middle back muscles. In the previous practice, we exercised our lower back with the Bhu Namanasana. Now for Skanda Chakra, stretch out the arms in the front. We have selected the asanas which will be visible for everyone to do. Now bend from the elbows and put the fingertips on the shoulders, join the elbows, head upright, close the eyes and breathing in, let the elbows come off closer to the ears and back, push the elbows back as much as possible and breathing in, come back to the center, breathing in, up and breathing out, down, breathing in, up. Do three more rounds yourself while keeping the eyes closed with a smile on the face, head upright. Yes, now do it on the opposite side, turn, let the elbows come down, breathing in and breathing out, up. The key point is to push the elbows as much as possible while they are going back so that chest will remain open and you are breathing in while letting the elbows to come off and breathing out while the elbows are going down. After completing, stretch out the arms, put the hands on the top of the thighs, still keep the back upright and eyes closed and observe few rounds of normal breathing. Yes, next we will go to the neck area. It's the delicate part of our body. It's connecting the brain with the body with the nerve channels, and this area though we are taking it very easy, but it's a very important area. Suddenly we are becoming tensed and so getting soft, and that phobia is there. So neck, for the neck exercise, we will bring the chin to the chest, and let the head rotate to the right shoulder and back, so that upper back of the head is touching to the upper back. Then left ear is coming to the left shoulder and to the front, into the chest. Very slowly, breathing in, let the elbows go up over the right shoulder, back. And breathing out over the left shoulder, down to the chest. And now change the direction to the opposite side. Yes, breathing in, head is going backwards. And breathing out is coming forwards. Continue one more round very slowly with breath awareness and while feeling the effects on the neck and the shoulders. And after completing, let the head come to the upright position. Still keep the eyes closed for some time and observe few rounds of normal breathing. Feel you are getting charged with the incoming vital energy while breathing in. And let go the tiredness, the tensions that you have created by exercising and stretching and toning few of the muscles in the body. Next, can open the eyes and we'll go for a very important practice, that is Vajrasana. So stretch out the legs in the front. Yes, for Vajrasana, we need to bend our knees and sit between the heels. So one of the demonstrators will go move to the back so that can see the position of the feet. See, the big toes are together, heels are separated, and we need to keep our hips in between the heels. Knees should be together in the front, palms on the thighs, back straight, head upright. This is the only posture in yoga can be done after the foot. It may be after the dinner, after the lunch, after the breakfast, but it is must, because there is a psychic center behind the navel in the inner wall of the spinal cord where medical science is telling about the solar plexus. And according to the yogis, whenever somebody is sitting in this Vajrasana after the foot, then that psychic center is getting stimulated, is sufficient energy, psychic energy is getting released. And it's very helpful for the organs in the digestive system for the proper digestion of the food. So it is very important. Now the situation we can say, everybody should have the attempt to sit in Vajrasana at least for 2 minutes in the beginning and increasing up to 10 5 to 10 minutes if we'll sit, then it's very helpful for our digestive system. Yes, from this Vajrasana, we'll go for a practice which will open our chest, which will be very helpful to exercise our lungs. So for this Ustrasana, let us stand on our knees and separate the knees as for the width of our hips. So hips width gaps would be between the feet as well as between the knees. Now stretch out the arms to the sides. Yes, and bending back, put the right hand on the right heel and left hand on the left heel, and push the abdomen forward and key point is to keep the thighs vertical to the ground and head is hanging between. Now we'll come back while breathing in, come back and breathing out, relax, sit down in Vajrasana, sit down back in Vajrasana. Yes, close the eyes for some time and try to absorb the sensation in the back muscles as there is at the same time while opening the chest, opening the front of the neck as well as stretching the abdominal area. We have also massaged the back muscles, the spinal muscles in this posture. So yes, now we will go for the next practice, which is the combination of two postures, Sasanka Bhujangasana. For this, we need to go from this Vajrasana to the Sasankasana. Yes, for Sasankasana, raise the arms up, straight up, closer to the ears, and breathe in, raise your spine up more, and breathing out with the synchronization of exhalation, bend down, bring the forehead down to the ground. See, hips should not be lifted from the heels. Hips should be in contact with the heels. And we can see in this posture how there is a good exercise of the digestive organs because the abdomen is getting pressed by the thighs. There is a relaxation one can feel on the back muscles as head is down. So there is a good flow of the oxygenated blood to the brain. So it is very good for the brain power. And now breathing in, just sliding the chest and chin on the ground, go forward, bend back to Bhujangasana. Yes. Again, hips up, head down, back to Sasankasana. Breathing in, come forward, sliding the chest and chin, bend back, hips down, looks up. Breathing out, head down, hips back to the heels. One more round. Breathing in, come forward, bend back, looks up, and breathing out, head down, hips up, down to the ground. Yes, now breathing in, raise the arms up, come up, and breathing out, release the arms. The sequence posture to this Sasanka Bhujangasana is Tadasana, a standing posture. So now everyone, please stand up for the Tadasana. So Tadasana is a very good posture to release the stress from the whole muscles of our body. So interlock the fingers, put the palms on the head. Look to a point in the front and a point just above at the level of the eyes. Then keeping the eyes fixed in the front, turn the palms out and raise the body up, arms up and come up to the toes. Yes, stop the movement. And breathing out, bring the palms down, simultaneously heels to the ground. Next, again, breathing in, stretch the body up, arms up as if you are going to touch the ceiling. Heels up, balancing on the toes, and breathing out, come down to the starting position. One more round, breathing in, come off. Stretch the whole body and feel the sensation in the hamstrings, in the sides of the trunk, in the shoulders. And breathing out, come back down to the starting position. Release the hands, close the eyes for some time and feel the sensation for the after effect of this practice in the whole body. Simultaneously observe the breath, how the body is discharging the discomforts, tiredness and tensions. At the same time, with each inhalation, the body is getting the vital energy, the prana, which is available sufficiently in our surroundings. So these are such techniques which are helpful to have our immune power, to have the vital energy. And yes, next we'll go for the Tiryak Tadasana. So for this, just separate the legs. Interlock the fingers. Stretch arms up. Yes. And throughout the practice, the key point is to keep the arms straight and closer to the ears. And now, breathing out, bend down to the right side. Without bending the knee, chest should remain open. Shoulders should remain in a vertical position. Breathing in, come back to the center. Breathing out, bend to the left side. Yes. And breathing in, come off, back to the center. One more round. Breathing out to the right. Chest should remain open. You are facing to the front. Breathing in, come off. And breathing out, bend to the left. Bend to the left. Yes. And breathing in, come off. Breathing out, release the arms. Fit together. Still keep the eyes closed for some time. And observe the sensation in the body, particularly in the shoulders, arms, sides of the groin. These two postures, Tadasana before this and the Tiryak Tadasana, this second one, these both are very helpful for the exercise of our intestine at the same time. So they are helping in the morning for the proper evacuation. If after drinking 10 to 15 or 2-3 glasses of volume or water in the morning, these three postures, if we go for these two postures around 10 rounds each, then this morning the constipation like problems will not be there, which will be very helpful to have the strong immune system, immune power within. We can, in yoga, they are known as if the treatment without medicine, like for the constipation. And yes, we will go for the next, that is the Kati Chakrasana. For this, we need to keep the legs separated from each other. Arms to the sides at the level of the shoulders. First of all, put the right arm just behind the waistline and left hand on the right shoulder. Look back behind. So dhyan rahe, the hips should be facing forward from the waist. We are turning back and looking back as much as possible, straight behind. Breathing in, come back to the center, stretch the arms. Breathing out, twist to the left side. And look back, see the hips should face forward. And yes, breathing in, come back to the center. Breathing out, go for the second round to the right, look back. Breathing in, come back to the center. Open the chest and breathing out to the left side. Look back, straight behind on the wall. Breathing in, come back to the center and breathing out, release the arms. Fit together, close the eyes for some time. It's very important to absorb the after effect of the practice. So we need to keep the eyes closed after each posture and feel the sensation in the body. It's the physical awareness as well as being aware of the breathing. We can have the mental awareness at the same time. So it's very helpful to release sufficient carbon from the body during this time and take sufficient vital energy. Just become aware of this incoming breath, how we are becoming charged and getting relaxed after breathing out. So these are such type of postures we have selected. Everybody can go, from small children to the senior citizens, everyone can go, and to build up a discipline at the physio-psychological level. So now we will go for the pranayama. For the chest related, basically the backward bending postures are very helpful. So for this, let us see some of the postures like Gomukhasana. So sit down, stretch the legs in the front for Gomukhasana. Yes. So for Gomukhasan, bend the right knee, put it on the left thigh, and left knee down. Yes. Knee should remain in a vertical position. Yes. For Gomukhasan. Yes. Knees should remain in a vertical position. Now right arm up, because the right knee on the top, so right arm will go up, and will one has to interlock the fingers at the back. You can change to the opposite side so that the back side, what how the leg position is, the hand position is there, it can be visible. Yes. So this is such a posture which is opening the chest, good for the lungs. It exercises the back muscles, good for the shoulders and arms, as well as the leg muscles and the joints. Yes. Now release the hands. It should be repeated on the opposite side. So in the second half, the left knee should come up and right knee down. So its key point is to keep the knees in a vertical position, because the left knee on the top, so left hand will come off, and right hand will come from down, hands are interlocked, or we can keep the palms together like this. Yes. Now release the hands, stretch the legs in the front, relax. Yes. So one more posture which will also open the chest, like the Purna Matsyendrasana. So for Purna Matsyendrasana, can see the posture, one of the leg on the top of opposite thigh. This is Matsyasana, yes. With the support of the elbows, bend back. And with the support of the hands, crown will be on the ground. Yes. While keeping the elbows on the ground, one needs to hold the toes. This opens the chest, it's good for the lungs, and it stretches the abdominal organs and stretches the front of the neck. Good for the shoulders as well as the back muscles. Yes, can release. With the support of the hands, can come off. And Purna Matsyendrasana. Can go for the Purna Matsyendrasana. Yes, Purna Artha Matsyendrasana. That is, it is quite advanced, so it will take time for a common human being to go for this posture. See the posture where one of the foot is against the abdomen and another foot in outside of the knee, and the person is holding from backside the heel, and chest is open, so it is good for the lungs again. So now you can release the right hand, then the left hand, and release the leg. Yes. Okay, now you can close the eyes. Sit in a cross-leg posture. After the asana, it's very important to observe the breath. Within 2 minutes, we'll know about the pranayama. It's very important, as pranayama is to have the vital energy in the body. It's a very beautiful technique. And we'll go for the Nadi Shodhana. It's very usual, very popular and common practice. For this, we'll have the Nasagra Mudra. So with tips of the index finger and middle finger will be at the eyebrow center. Eyes will remain closed. Raise the right nostril with the thumb. And through the left one, we need to breathe in as much as possible, fill our lung and close it, and open the right nostril, breathe out. Then breathe in through the right, take sufficient air as much as possible, and breathe out, release through the left nostril. This is one round, like this as much as time is available, or as many as rounds one can go for, can do it every day on the regular basis, minimum 9 rounds like this. This is the alternate nostril breathing, second stage of Nadi Shodhana. Yes. So as time is very short, we will stop here the practice. So release the hands as there is the instruction. the message is that to go for the question answer session. So yes, sir, I'll invite for the question.
If anybody has any question, then they can ask. Apna pakre jodi kichhi prashna pachhara achi, Dr. Swai, Dr. Pratibha ko apna pachari paribe. Khali anurodh karibi je question ta mana lamba na kari ki ete sankshipt rahi paribo.
So should we do the yoga and empty stomach, Dr. Dinesh?
Yes, yes, sir. It's empty stomach yoga practices, and it's the best time is the morning. That is why, and evening as after lunch we are getting 3 to 4 hours. So it is good. The second option is evening. Otherwise, empty stomach. Yes, yes, the morning time is the best time for yoga practice.
Also. So during COVID, what are the exercises you suggest during infection and after recovery? So first, tell about during infection. What are the? Yeah.
Sir, for this actually the Dalmati in the beginning I told that is very good to exercise. To clean our nasal cavity. What the Dalmati is a cleansing practice is there, and at the same time. During this time, little exercise. Even if the person is on the bed, can go for little exercises like anti-rheumatic group of asanas, just joint movements. In the beginning, we started with 2 asanas. One is butterfly pose, another is the Skanda Chakra. These are yes, this is the neti pot. I can show is a very good practice to keep our it's number one technique. We can say Jalneti. For the respiratory system to have the healthy respiratory system, it is very good, and that also during the COVID one can go for it on the regular basis, and at the same time during this time just meditation, and even if go for the yoga nidra that is of half an hour practice minimum. That will give the relaxation around of 4 hours of sleep, half an hour of yoga nidra technique, and
we request everyone who are having COVID now or recovered, yoga nidra is a must. Try to practice this. It's not a simply a way of meditative sleep. I think that will help your stress, anxiety related to COVID to be relieved to much extent. Yeah?
Yes.
Then sir, what about breathing exercises you recommend? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Pranayam is a must. Like this Nadi Shodhana, what in the demonstration it was there. If the person is very weak, in that case, that is unable to sit and all, he must be taking rest and sleeping on the bed. And being there also, just close the eyes. Need to close the eyes and observe the movement of the abdomen, because spontaneously, whenever we are inhaling. The abdominal muscles are coming outwards, and when we are exhaling, abdominal muscles are going downwards. No need to put effort. Just silently observe the breath at the simultaneously the movement of the abdomen and count backwards from 100 to 0 without making mistake. If coming to 80, if the count we are forgetting, then again we have to go back from 100 and start again to count our breath movement of the abdomen from 100 back to 0. It will take hardly 5 to 10 minutes, and if it can be done, it's very simple and very good technique. Because our mind will be under our control. At the same time, we can feel the sensation of that vitality soon after this 100 counts. Backward counts should be there of the abdominal movement. That is known as the abdominal breathing, where breathing pranayama is there as well as the exercise of the abdomen is there. So, and at the same time, a sense of relaxation. If we'll try it, then only we can have the effect. Just by listening or by simply telling about it, the benefit one cannot. It may be very simple, but very effective. One can feel soon after going for 100 backward counts of the abdominal movement, movement while breathing in and out. yes. So we had in the schedule today, but because of the lack of time, we could not able to display. Otherwise, it's very simple technique and but very effective one. And yoga nidra, that is also important. Half an hour of yoga nidra, as well as Nadi Shodhan, whatever was in the demonstration today, and Bhramari Pranayam. Everybody knows about that, where chest remains open. We are closing the flaps of the ears, facing the flaps of the ears to close the ears through the index fingers and doing the humming sound continuously. 15 to 20 rounds of this Bhramari Pranayam is also very helpful, and it's counted as a number one technique in the stress management. What in yoga, the techniques are there available. Yes.
Many thanks, Dr. Dinesh and Dr. Pratibha, for an, I'll say, enlightening session. And I'll say it has kind of mind empowered the mind of all of us and has given us a different perspective how to control our mind and how to control and channelize our energy. We look forward to many more sessions from you. From Odia Samaj, on behalf of Odia Samaj, I would like to thank you again for the time that you have given. Moving ahead, Moine Dr. Ashok Chaudhary ko anurodh karibi. Nota das heigalani sir, amar jo aga din man pare kon am sab kaam kariba taku tik sankhep pare kahibe. Nota das heigalani to mate laguchi ame jo audience bhi achanti onte upre am sang rahileni. To Dr. Chaudhary.
Thank you everyone for remaining glued to the program. So just quickly I can say that this wellness program will cover all aspects about stress management, mindfulness, meditation practices, yoga, naturopath, ayurved, homeopathy. So all spectrum that is called as the holistic health will be covered, and we planned every Wednesday and Saturday 8 to 9 p.m. So please, I request everyone to put their calendar marked for 8 to 9 p.m. For something for themselves only, that is the wellness. Because disease, something makes you to go to the hospital. But wellness makes you something to make yourself healthy, not to take the treatment. Rather, you can have a preventive approach. Then at the same time, we have taken into much of practical things like a small home. Most of the people in Delhi remaining in one BHK room. So how they will practice the isolation practices? That is a very much need of the practice. How your kids are getting addicted to the digitals. You are getting glued to the news media. So how to manage with this? Then what is the psychological prospects of this COVID or job or employment related stress? That also will be assessed by a good psychologist. Then obviously during this, you have to remain fit. How your diet and nutrition, we have to think of what is the fitness you should take at home also during shutdown or lockdowns. And last, the nutrition and what is your well-being and what are the diet practices should be done. So all these areas will be covered one by one. And that's why I request every Wednesday and Saturday, 8 to 9, keep your dates blocked. And on Tuesday or Wednesday, in 2-3 days, we'll intimate. But already we have started taking the calls. So our telemedicine is going to happen every day 6 to 8 p.m. for routine doctor's consultation. And also for the numbers, I think the flyers has been circulated. You can get it also. And they will do the teleconsultation on WhatsApp or call basis. That will be also intimated. So these are the holistic approaches, both for the treatment, both for the prevention, as well as for your mental peace in a larger way. Thank you. Please be with us.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद डॉक्टर चौधरी. डॉक्टर चौधरी भी हैज बीन द मोटिवेटिंग फैक्टर फॉर द एंटायर प्रोग्राम. एंड वी एट उड़िया समाज इज ग्रेटफुल. वी ऑल आर ग्रेटफुल फॉर हिज काइंड टाइम एंड हेल्प. वी आल्सो हैव मिस्टर प्रशांत मोहंती ऑफ बीवीओ हेल्थ, द प्लेटफॉर्म दैट यू विल बी यूजिंग, एंड इन द डेज टू कम वी विल बी नोइंग अबाउट द प्लेटफॉर्म इन मच मच मोर डिटेल. वी आर कमिंग टू द एंड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. मुझे ट्रस्टी श्री हिरण्य महांती को अनुरोध करी धन्यवाद प्रस्ताव रखिए. श्री हिरण्य महांती.
जय जगन्नाथ. हैप्पी सैटरडे टू ऑल आवर डिग्निटरीज, गेस्ट स्पीकर्स ऑफ द डे, एंड टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स इन इंडिया एंड ओवरसीज वाचिंग दिस सेशन. दिस इज द फर्स्ट वेलनेस सेशन इनिशिएटेड बाय उड़िया समाज कॉल्ड Odia Samaj COVID care on the wake of this COVID-19 pandemic. Ladies and gentlemen, I am personally feeling very happy attending this beautiful session today, which is going to benefit immensely to me and my family wellness and well-being both. Dr. Authare talked about the positivity and its power to fight back the anxiety when the situation is volatile. I personally trust that many of the participants today will carry along lots of positivity, and as a result, ultimately, the power of positivity will overpower the COVID positive pandemic shortly. I, on behalf of Odia Samaj, our technology partner BVO Healthcare for telemedicine, and Dr. Ashok Chaudhary, take this opportunity to convey our sincere thank you to Dr. Dinesh Swain, Dr. Prathibha Sri, and one young boy was there in the demonstration in the yoga, to him also. Lots of thank you. And you know, this was nothing but a joyride. This yoga ride was a joyride. I consider it as a beautiful experience today. And this is going to establish harmony between mind, body, and spirit. And it is going to be the integral part of the life. And I see and I wish that it may become the new normal, like mask wearing, social distancing, and sanitation. The relevance of yoga continues in before corona era, during corona era, and AC after corona era. Sincere thanks to Dr. Authare for his valuable information sharing related to diet, immune boosting food, authentic source of COVID-related data, defining risk, moderate, and mild COVID patients categorization, sleep advice, breathing exercise, etc. Everything is very, very important, very critical information. And we are truly humbled with your presence today, sir. I thank you, Siddhar sir, Dr. Chaudhary, and Sandeep for the setting the tone of the session and navigating the session beautifully and meaningful closure. With this, I have the permission to close the session for the today. And with a big thank you to our big guys, big audience of the session, I wish happy weekend, happy yoga, happy meditation. Love, care, and prayers for all of you. Jai Jagannath.
Jai Jagannath.